children, welcome back to the online class. In this class, you will be learning about computers at your cycle. In the previous class, you have learned that all machines follow a cycle that is known as IPO cycle. Let us see.
Now, let's know about computers IPO cycle. In the previous class, you have learnt that all machines follow a cycle that is known as IPO cycle. Let us know in detail. Here instruction is given to add 2 and 3. The computer CPU calculate. Finally got answer 2 plus 3 equal to 5. Then what is data? Data is the text or number that we give to the computer. Once again, what is data? Data is the text or numbers that we give to the computer. See here, data we are giving 2 and 3. Then what are the instructions? Instructions are the command that we give to the computer. Here command is given to add. In the same way, we can give subtract, multiply, divide, etc. So, input given to the computer are data and instruction. What input we give to the computer? Data and instruction. The computer process the data according to the command or instruction we give to it. And finally, we got the answer or output 5. So, computer also follow a IPO cycle. Now, let's do the exercise given in page number 12. See in the picture, here data, input is data and instruction and here computer process it and we get the output. So let understand with example, input, process, output. Data 10, 10. Instruction is to subtract. So here process will be 10 minus 10. And in output we will get 0. Next, data is 2, 2. Instruction is to add. So computer will process it and it will add 2 plus 2 and in output we will get 4. Then here data is 5, 7. Instruction is to add. So computer will process 5 plus 7. In output we will get 12. So sometimes we give many instructions to a computer. And do you know, a set of instruction is called program. A set of instruction is called a program. When we give a lot of instruction and all together it is called a program. Now, let's know about the features of computer. Computer has different features. Let us see one by one. First, speed, accuracy, storage, versatility, automation, diligence. Let us see one by one. First, speed. Computer can work extremely fast. An average common desktop computer can perform millions of instructions in 1 second. For example, if I give you to multiply 9099 into 4069, you will take little time, but computer will do the calculation within a second. So computers are very fast. Now, computers are very accurate. Computer never make mistake. Mistakes can be made by the user, but never by the computer. Mistakes can be made by us, but not by the computer. Next features, multitasking. Computer can do many things at the same time. We can listen song, we can do typing, we can write a letter, we can send message. Means computer can do a many thing at the same time. Computer are multi-purpose. Computer can be used to perform different types of tasks. For example, they can be used to draw, paint, calculate, design or store data. They can be used for many type of work. For weather forecast, for calculation, for drawing, for designing. It is used for many purpose. Then computer has a large memory. Computer can store a huge amount of data on the storage devices. There are different storage devices of computer such as RAM, ROM, CD, DVD, hard disk. These are the storage devices of computer. It can store a huge amount of data. Now let's see the difference between computers and human being. First, computers work very fast. Computers work very fast. But human cannot always work very fast. Second, it is always accurate. Computer never make mistake. Mistake can be made by us, but not by computer. Human can make mistake. We can make mistake. We are not accurate. Third, computer can do many things at the same time. Computer can do many things. In computer we can type, do calculation, play song. We can do many things, or computer can do many things at the same time. But human being cannot always do many things at the same time. Fourth, computer does not get tired. When we play games, we get tired, but computer never get tired. Human being get tired and need rest. Fifth, computer can store large amount of information permanently. Computer has a storage device. It can store a large amount of information. But human may forget things after some time. It is a natural that we can forget the things after some time. Thank you. Hope you have understood this chapter.